Everybody, it's Stephanie here with I'll Buy the Popcorn. Thank y'all for clicking on this video. If you're someone who enjoys talking about film, how about clicking that subscribe button? So today we're going to be talking about Prime Video's newest film, One Night in Miami. Now, One Night in Miami is a rated R drama. It is an hour and 54 minutes long. It is directed by Regina King. It is her featured directorial debut. Now, this is a fictional encounter about a night that actually happened, but we, of course, don't know what actually went down within that hotel room that night in Miami, February 25th, 1965. It's based off of a play. This night does take place after Cassius Clay title win against Sonny Liston, his surprising win, and then the next day is when he does convert to the Muslim faith and then changes his name to Muhammad Ali. Now, this is really just a conversation within these four men. They think they're gonna go party, but Malcolm X has some different plans in mind. Basically, we are in a discussion of the responsibilities of being a successful black man during the civil rights movement. I'm not gonna lie, I've said this many, many times before, I did not pay attention in history class. I didn't even know these four men were friends in real life. I'm not even gonna lie. Now, the standout for a lot of people in the movie, of course, is Kingsley, who plays Malcolm X, and Leslie Odom Jr., who plays Sam Cooke. Now, they do absolutely amazing. I'm sure Kingsley's gonna be nominated for an Oscar. I mean, all these men, you guys, did absolutely amazing. For me, Eli stole the show. Honestly, for me personally, I know, like I said, everybody loves Kingsley and loves Leslie. Me personally, I love Eli because he played Cassius Clay so greatly. I loved everything about him. And he really was that comedic relief within the movie. I just loved his performance. He was really like, ay, que bonito, soy, que chulo, soy, como me quiero. But he really was always like, damn, Monarch, good looking. And I loved him. Only one that I feel didn't have like a huge part within the movie was Jim Brown. These four characters, well, these four people, right? Like their friendship, their bond. And, you know, whether it's them just laughing and cracking jokes or getting like right down serious to, hey man, just have some damn ice cream. It is based off of a play for the most part within one location, which would be a hotel room. The blocking was great. The music was great. The direction was absolutely amazing as well. Like I said, Regina King, wow, I love her. Also, the way that we were introduced to the characters in the beginning of the movie, I absolutely loved it. One issue though that I do have with the movie would be the pacing. I don't think it goes as smoothly. I feel personally it was a little bit too long. I did catch myself looking at the time a couple times. Before I do give you my final score, if you haven't already, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I am trying to hit 500 subscribers this year. It is a small goal, but yeah, it is a big goal as well. And that would be awesome if you would help me get there. Of course, don't forget to give this video a like, comment, follow me on my social media. So One Night in Miami, even though I did have a few problems with the pacing, personally, it was an enjoyable film overall. I really did enjoy Regina King's direction that she took with the movie. I think it was done absolutely wonderful. There's amazing performances by all these actors. So with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and give One Night in Miami a medium popcorn. If you've seen One Night in Miami, go ahead and let me know down below. Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Was it just not for you? Are you planning on seeing it? Did you get a chance to see it last year? Again, this is another one that did have a limited release in 2020. But again, like my previous two videos, I saw it in 2021. So it is going to be incorporated within my 2021 watches. But of course, like always, until next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.